Magandang buhay po at welcome po muli kayo dito sa aking Mathematics Tagalog tutorial. Sa video na ito ay papaliwanag ko po sa inyo regarding polynomial function on how to find or calculate the x and y intercepts. For example, find the x and y intercepts of the graphs of polynomial functions. For number 1, ang given function is factored out already. For number 2, ang given polynomial function is not factored out. This is third degree. For number 3, not factored out, third degree. And for number 4 example, ay not factored out, this is fourth degree. So, paano nga po ba i-calculate yung x and y intercepts? So, yan po at iba pa, ang aking pong ipapaliwanag step by step. Okay, so let's start. Calculate the x and y intercepts. So, for number 1, y is equal to x minus 2 times x minus 1 times x plus 3. So, yung given polynomial function natin ay factored out already. So, meaning to say, madali pong i-calculate yung x and y intercepts. Okay, so paano nga po ba? Unahin po natin yung y-intercept. To solve for the y-intercept, let x is equal to 0. So, ito po yung ating given na polynomial function. Lahat po ng variable x dyan ay lagyan po natin or isubstitute po natin yung 0. Okay? So, it's become y is equal to x minus 2 po yan. Yung x, gawin po natin 0. So, x, then minus 2. And then next, second factor, x minus 1. So, x yan, then that will become 0 minus 1. And then, sa last factor, x plus 3. Yung x ulit, lagyan po ulit natin ng 0. So, 0 plus 3. Okay? And then, simplify the result. First factor, 0 minus 2, that is negative 2. Second factor, 0 minus 1, that is negative 1. And third factor, 0 plus 3, that is equal to 3. Now, you are going to multiply. What is negative 2 times negative 1? Positive 2. So, positive 2 times 3, that is equal to positive 6. So, y is equal to 6, meaning to say, the y-intercept is equal to 6. How about yung kanyang x-intercept? So, to solve for the x-intercept, let y is equal to 0. So, madali lang po ito kasi yung given po natin ay factored out. So, let y is equal to 0, this will become 0 is equal to. Okay? So, since factored out, kukunin lang po natin yung value ng x. So, sa first factor, x minus 2, change the sign, minus magiging positive. So, x is equal to positive 2. Then, second factor, x minus 1. Since minus 1, the value of x is equal to positive 1. And then, sa third factor, x plus 3, change the sign, the value of x is equal to negative 3. So, therefore, the three values of x are 2, 1, and negative 3. So, yan po yung kanilang x-intercepts. So, 2, 1, and negative 3. Okay, so how about this number 2 example? Y is equal to x cubed minus 4x squared plus x plus 6. Yung given po natin na polynomial function is not factored out. So, medyo may proseso po tayong gagawin to solve for the x-intercept. So, unahin po natin yung y-intercept. Again, let x is equal to 0 to solve for the y-intercept. So, ito po yung ating given polynomial function. So, lahat po ng x dyan, substitute po natin yung 0. So, let's become y is equal to x cubed, so 0 raised to the third power, then minus 4x squared, so 4 times x is 0, so 0 raised to the second power, then next there is plus x is 0 again, then plus 6. Okay? Then simplify yung exponent, y is equal to 0 raised to the third power is 0 minus 4 times 0 is squared. Since 0 po, multiplication, that is equal to 0. Okay? Then, plus 0, plus 6. If you are going to simplify, 0 minus 0, plus 0, plus 6, that is equal to positive 6. So, y is equal to 6, yan po yung kanyang y-intercept. So, y-intercept is equal to 6. Okay? So, how about for the x-intercept? Let y is equal to 0. So, ito po yung given natin na polynomial function. So, yung y po ay gawin po natin 0. So, 0 is equal to yung ating pong polynomial function. Okay. So, in this case, hindi po factored out yung given na function. Ibig sabihin, kailangan pong i-factor natin para ma-solve natin yung value ng x for the x-intercept. Okay? So, dito po natin gawin. So, 0 is equal to x cubed minus 4x squared plus x plus 6. So, paano po natin gagawin yan na ipa-factor? Ganito lang po yun. Gamit po tayo ng synthetic division or remainder theorem. So, ang gagawin ko po dito ay synthetic division to find out the value of x. Okay? So, unahin po natin yung first term, x cubed. Kunin po natin yung numerical coefficient, that is 1, para magamit po natin yung synthetic division. Next term ay minus 4x squared, that is negative 4, numerical coefficient niya. Third term, x, so that is positive 1. At last term ay 6. So, yan po yung mga numerical coefficient ng bawat terms. Okay, so ano po yung ating i-divide? Ano po yung ating divisor? Una, tignan po natin yung last term natin, yung constant, which is equal to 6. Ano po yung mga possible factors of 6? So, pwede po dyan ang 3 and 2. So, try po natin yung 3 kung factor po niya. Okay? So, ilagay po natin dito sa my left side 3. And then, i-perform po natin ang synthetic division. Okay? To perform synthetic division, bring down the first number, that is 1. And then, multiply po natin yung 1 dun sa 3 na kinuha natin, yung divisor natin sa left side. So, 1 times 3 is equal to 3. Ilagay po natin yung sagot sa next term, sa baba po. So, what is negative 4 plus 3? So, pag magkaiba po yung sign, you are going to subtract. Okay? So, 4 minus 3 is equal to 1. And then, yung sign po niya ay yung sign ng higher number. So, that is negative 1. Okay? Yung negative 1, multiply po natin ulit sa 3 sa left side. So, negative 1 times 3 is equal to negative 3. Ilagay po natin yung sagot doon sa next term. Okay? So, what is 1 plus negative 3? Again, magkaiba yung sign. Subtract. 3 minus 1 is 2. And then, copy the sign of the higher number. Kaya negative 2 yan. Okay? Then, multiply natin negative 2 times 3. That is negative 6. Okay? And add 6 plus negative 6 is equal to 0. Since yung ating pong last number ay 0, ibig sabihin, factor po niya yung 3 na tinest po natin. And that is the value of x. Ano po? So, ito na yung unang value ng x natin, that is equal to 3. Okay, so determine po natin yung remainder o yung quotient po niya, rather. Okay, ito po yung magiging equation natin or second equation natin. So, negative 2, then next dyan ay magiging, since negative 1, lalagyan po natin yan ng x, that will become negative 1x. And then, yung pangatlong number po ay magiging x squared na po yan. So, 1x squared na po yan. So, yan na po yung bago nating equation. Okay, so para masolve po yung dalawa pang value ng x, gamitin po natin itong bago nating equation. Okay, so 1x squared minus 1x minus 2. In this case, this is quadratic equation, so gagamitin po natin yung factoring para makuha po yung value ng x. So, paano po i-factor yan? Gawa po tayo ng dalawang parenthesis. Yung first term natin ay x squared. So, factor lang po natin since ang a natin ay 1 o yung numerical coefficient po ng x squared ay 1. Madali lang po yan. So, x times x lang po yan sa dalawang parenthesis. Then next, yung last term po natin ay negative 2. So, ano po yung factors ng negative 2? That if you're going to add, that is equal to negative 1, yung middle numerical coefficient po natin. So, ang factors po ng negative 2 ay 2 and 1. So, 2 times 1 is equal to 2. But, tingnan po natin yung sign, negative 2. So, isa pong addition dyan at isa pong subtraction. Okay? So, ano po yung addition dyan at ano po yung subtraction? Yung middle term po natin ay minus 1x. So, minus 1, ibig sabihin, negative po yung mas malaking factor. So, yung 2 po ang negative at yung 1 naman ang positive. So, x minus 2 and x plus 1 are the factors. So, to solve for x, yung first factor, x minus 2, that is equal to, x is equal to 2, just change the sign. At yung second factor, x plus 1, x is equal to negative 1. So, ilagay po natin doon, sama po natin, x is equal to 2, and x is equal to negative 1. So, tatlo na po yung value ng x. Okay? 3, 2, and negative 1. So, the x-intercepts are 3, 2, and negative 1. Okay, so bago ko po i-present yung number 3 example, click lang po muna ang like and then subscribe kung bago ka pa lang po sa aking channel. Upang sa gaon, kapag ikaw po ay may katanungan at nag-comment ka po at ako po ay nag-reply, ay manonotify po kayo. Okay, so for number 3 example, y is equal to x cubed plus x squared minus 12x. So 3 terms po yung ating polynomial function. Unahin po natin to solve for the y-intercept, let x is equal to 0. Okay? So, lahat po ng x dyan ay substitute po natin yung 0. So, this will become y is equal to x cubed, kaya magiging 0 cubed plus x squared, kaya magiging 0 squared, then minus 12x, so 12 times 0. If you're going to simplify, 0 cubed is 0 plus 0 squared is 0 minus 12 times 0 is 0. So, if you're going to simplify, that will become 0. So, y is equal to 0. Therefore, y-intercept is equal to 0. Okay, so how about for the x-intercept? Let y is equal to 0. So, ito po yung ating polynomial function. Gawin po natin yung y is equal to 0. So, 0 is equal to x cubed plus x squared minus 12x. So, in this case, magiging cubic equation na po ito. So, ang gagawin lang po natin ulit dito ay ipa-factor po natin yung ating pong equation. Okay? So, dito po natin ipa-factor sa right side. X cubed plus x squared minus 12x. If you notice, yung ating pong first term x cubed, second term x squared, last term 12x. Lahat po sila ay may x. So, ibig sabihin, meron po silang common monomial factor. Okay? So, ano po yung common monomial factor po nila? X po. Lahat po silang term ay may x. So, ilabas po natin yung x as a common factor. Okay? So, para po makuha yung isang factor, yung first term po ay x cubed. Since nilabas po natin yung isang x, tanggal po natin yung isang x. So, ang matitira po sa x cubed magiging x squared na lang. Then, second term plus x squared po yan. Pag tinanggal yung isang x, magiging x na lang. And then, yung last term, 12x. Pag kinuha o tinanggal yung x, magiging 12 na lang po yan. Okay? So, yung first factor ay x. At ito po yung second factor niya, x squared plus x minus 12. In this case, kailangan pa po nating i-factor itong second factor niyang x squared plus x minus 12. Again, that is quadratic, kaya gagamitin lang po natin dyan ay factoring method. Okay, so yung first term natin ay x squared, factor po natin, so x times x. And then, tingnan po natin yung last term natin, negative 12. What are the factors of negative 12 that if you're going to add, that is equal to the middle term natin, yung numerical coefficient niya, that is positive 1. So, ang factors po ng negative 12 ay 4 and 3. At asaan po dyan ang minus at asaan po dyan yung plus? Since yung middle term natin ay plus, so ibig sabihin, yung higher number po dyan ang plus. So, 4 po ang plus kasi mas malaki at yung 3 po ang minus. Okay, so x plus 4 and x minus 3 are the factors. So, ano po ang value ng x sa x plus 4? That is equal to negative 4. Just change the sign. At ang value po ng x sa x minus 3 is equal to positive 3. So, ibaba po natin yung first factor natin kaninang x. So, ano po yung value ng x kapag ang factor lang po ay x? That is equal to 0. So, x is equal to 0. Okay, meron na po tayong 3 values for x. So, 0, negative 4, and 3. So, yan na po yung kanyang x-intercepts. 0, negative 4, and positive 3. Okay, so how about this number 4? Y is equal to 2x raised to the 4th power plus 8x cubed plus 4x squared minus 8x minus 6. Okay, we're going to solve for y-intercept. Let x is equal to 0. And to solve for the x-intercept, let y is equal to 0. So, ililib ko po yung o ito na inyong activity. So, pwede pong i-comment down your answer at sisend ko po sa inyo kung tama po o mali yung inyong sagot. Okay, so salamat sa iyong panonood, kaibigan. Kung nagustuhan mo yung video na ito, please click like and then subscribe na rin kung bago ka pa lang po dito sa aking channel.